Hey guys, Jengar here. Welcome to today's premium review in which we are taking a look at the German P47D16RE Razorback. More Razorbacks. They added three new Razorbacks in this patch. And now everybody has got them. Now, I mean, if it's historical, I don't really mind. The more planes, the merrier. But you're going to get a lot of stuff there with duplicates, and trees not being that unique anymore, but oh well, you know, it's a choice of things. I always say that I want more props, and I'm getting more props as well next to the jet, so I am a little bit content. But of course there are three Razorbacks of those prop planes, and it could be a little bit more diverse, but I don't want to nag. There's 50 new planes, and that's quite a nice amount. We have new graphic engine 6.0, and we have the clouds, lovely. Well, you debate that. I don't think they did a terrible job, but I don't think it's significantly better than the last iteration. I mean, some of the stuff looks nice from afar, but I mean, the old clouds also look fine from afar. I'm still a bit mixed on the clouds. But anyway, this video is not about the clouds. This video is about this German P47 that replaces, for people who didn't have it yet, the old bubble canopy Thunderbolt that the Germans had. I have that one as well, so people who had it, keep it. But for people who now want the German Thunderbolt, will get this Razorback at 4.0 battle rating. It is D16. It is quite earlier than most other P47 Razorbacks. So let's see what that does. It does have a little bit of an effect on the speed without web. If it comes to the details. The maximum speed in this plane at sea level without web is 495 kilometers an hour. And with web 548. At 4500 meters. Still go up to 452 without web and 500 with web. And finally at 6500 meters, still go up to 432 without web and 475 with web. Now these speeds are an indicated airspeed without mech. This plane is quite a bit slower than the American Razorback that was initially introduced. That one is about 25 kilometers an hour faster without web, but the speeds with war emergency power are quite similar. They have similar engines, but this one has about 60 horsepower less than the American version. And she is also a bit slower than the Brit version. I just didn't check the horsepower of that one, but this one, the engine is just slightly less powerful than the American one, and that just translates very well back to the speed. And a little bit in the performance, but that is just a little bit. It's not much. Compared to the British version, that was a little bit slower than the American version already, so that difference is only 10-15 kilometers. But that's not that much of a difference. The top speed in a dive in this plane is of course similar, it doesn't change, it has more to do with the airframe, is 841 kilometers an hour until she redlines, and 920/930 before she rips apart. Depends a bit on in what angle you're at and what exactly you're doing at the last moments before you get to that speed. If you're rolling around, you'll have a higher chance to snap slightly before, and then if in the case that you were holding the plane completely still. But all in all, that jet speed in a dive is very nice, and it's very nice on this one as well. I love that the paint scheme is the same as the old bubble canopy one, because I like this paint scheme. Control stiffening in the plane starts at 500 with a little tick in the roll rate and goes up to 750 for the second one. It stays very functional though after that, and doesn't compress that much after that. She stays functional right until the crash. Well, you have to pull out at 850, I would say, after the red line, and be quick about it. You do have 80 kilometers an hour, so that's quite a good window. But for the roll rate, it's good, but it's average when she's slow. And when you have those two ticks in compression on the roll rate, you will have a bit more like decent, not good, but decent. And but I like the plane when she's fast, of course, in except for the high ends. This is one of the better planes to have when it comes to the performance of the plane. The Thunderbolts and the Razorbacks, well, are made for that, and they are quite enjoyable when it comes to the high speed dives. Compression, so only severe after 750, and then you can debate about what severe really is, because some of the other planes that this plane faces, they already compress more than this plane compresses with the initial tick at 500, and that is just not too bad of an issue for this plane. Stall speed lies at 140 kilometers an hour, which is all right. You have, especially with the war emergency power, get a little bit of extra boost. The war emergency power on this plane brings it to the speeds that the American version had with the war emergency power as well. But the regular speeds are 25 kilometers an hour, 20-25 kilometers an hour slower. So it's interesting. A more powerful weapon, this one. The firepower on this plane is excellent, of course. You have 8 12.7mm M2 Browning machine guns with 425 rounds per gun. Brilliant. I used 600 meter convergence and a universal belt on this round. Fantastic ammo load. Also excellent. Quite effective. I think stealth, tracers, universal are all quite effective. Maybe even ground. I didn't check that out too much. But acceleration in a straight line is decent. But in a dive, it's very good. Needs to wind up a little bit, like the other Thunderbolts also need to do. But once you got to wind up, that acceleration in a dive starts to be really nice. And you really start to go down and catch people. It's a great plane in a dive, in the longer dive. Short dive is less spectacular when it comes to that dive performance. The energy retention in the plane is good in the horizontal and in the vertical, so it's both pretty good. I felt it was because of that extra strong web, it seemed to pull through the vertical a little bit better than the other Razorbacks, but maybe that was just my perspective. But that's what it seemed like to me, and it felt really good. The climb rate is only average though. Come up from the airfield and you do need to side climb in this plane, gather up to altitude somewhere around 5,000 to 6,000 meters. I wouldn't take this plane all the way up to 7 or 8 kilometers an hour kilometers an hour altitude, because this plane, it seems to be less spectacular on the higher altitudes, although it's still good there. Of course, it's a Thunderbolt, but the other Thunderbolts seem to be better above 6,000 meters, and this one seemed to have a little bit less performance there. But it's just, it is in the tiny margins, and because I just flew out the Razorbolts, the initial two recently, the British one, the premium one, and the American one, I have them fresh in my mind, reasonably fresh. So I seem to notice a difference on the higher altitudes in this German one, and but it's just slight. If I would not have flown the Razorbacks for a long time already, then I would not have noticed the difference, to be honest. So it's not spectacular differences there. You would say like, oh wow, this plane really is so much less good on the higher altitudes than the other ones. And it's not a lot. Anyway, so climb rate average. The turn time is below average. That's really not one of the fortes of this plane, except maybe the first few turns at higher altitudes. And for this plane, that would be between 5,000 and 6,000 meters. And then at a higher speed, between 450 and 650. That's where the plane with flaps can do some shenanigans. You have to be careful though, because the flaps do rip off at half of that, in the half of that window at 550. So in the first half of that speed window, you can use a bit of flaps. And you will be able to throw out one or two good turns, and then you get slower, and you'll get into trouble. So do make sure that it is a killing shot that you're doing that for, because otherwise you're going to be in trouble. And yeah, you don't want that. Nobody wants to be in trouble. Now here my ally should have killed him. It was a perfect bait, but he missed him, didn't kill him. We get shot on fire. This will give you a little bit of an insight into the durability of this Razorback. It is a Thunderbolt and they don't go down easily. I love these new flame. It's a bit much maybe, I don't know. I mean, when you shoot an enemy now, they pop on fire and they're like, you know, it's fireworks in the sky. It's nice visuals. I'm not going to complain. It looks nice. It looks satisfying. So all good. All good with that, Gaijin. Better than the clouds, I have to say. So turn time below average. Maybe a bit above average with the flaps. And you can surprise some people with that. Because most people, most planes perform less good on those higher altitudes. So that's only in very specific situations where you can get one or two turns out of this one. The roll rate is good. An average only below 300. Maneuverability is below average below 300 and decent above 400. Overheating in this plane is present, but it is definitely manageable. Yeah, she does overheat with web, but it seems to be less bad than it was on the other Razorbacks. Maybe they, you know, adjusted that in the meantime. I don't know. But when I was flying those two planes, they overheated quite badly, and this one doesn't have that. So it's either different for this plane, or it's just some adjustment they made for the Razorbacks in general, maybe for all the P-47s. Although I just noticed it on the Razorbacks, not on the other ones before that. Too badly. Anyway, it's manageable still. The durability is excellent. Can take a shit ton of damage, this plane. I got back to the airfield with that fire earlier. This plane is really a boom and zoomer first, and it can be a good energy fighter as well on the higher altitudes. On lower altitudes, you got to be a little bit careful because it loses some of the edge it had there. But yeah, we got a bit in a pickle here with three planes, two planes, these two coming in, me losing a bit of altitude for that plane. I had to eliminate them, but they came a little bit too early. So I'm now going to go for committed head-ons. A little bit too high, maybe. Did get a hit there. And the A-21's coming in. He hits me. I got an oil leak and some damage. And yeah, this is going to be difficult with the 109 behind me. The American one is fantastic, the F-4. And these two planes are also, I have to divide my attention. I want to go for the 109, but the other ones are already stalling up. Helicoptering up at me and not stalling out in time. So they got me. But this is a very good impression of what the plane can do. An ace in the first match and four kills in the second. Final blow, survivor, the best squad, terror of the sky, 140,000 silver lines and 25,000 research points. Nice reward, huh? I'll see you in the conclusion. Hey guys, so here we are after the match. Now we're in the new patch and we have a lot of planes. We have a lot of duplicates though, and a lot of slight adjustment to flight models we already know. Now this P-47 Razorback D-16 is an interesting plane because it has slight differences in the performance compared to some of the other Razorbacks that I like. And it was a joy to fly like the other Razorbacks. It's very lethal. These were actually my two games in it that I had this afternoon. That's why I could throw this video out to you. My first two matches in it were a lot of entertainment for you guys. So decided to use them immediately and make sure I had a video on the first night. But we also have the G4 that was introduced as a premium for the Italian. And we have two other Razorbacks. We have four Harriers, I believe. And then we have two Yak 38s, and we have some other stuff that is quite similar. We have the what was it again? The T1, or the, well, something with a one for the Japanese, that is a direct relative to the top tier jet that we already have there. I keep forgetting. these names. But anyway, we have a lot of similar flight models, I believe, that could be easily copy-pasted by Gaijin. But curious to your thoughts what you flew out first. But I decided to go for this Razorback. It was 1600 Golden Eagles, I believe. And it was a good buy. I think it's very worthy of that price. Definitely a premium that you should want to have in your collection. If you don't have the other one yet, this is definitely a no-brainer and will be worthy of the money. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button, become part of this community. If you are already a subscriber, don't forget to like the video, do leave me a comment, and if you really feel like helping out today, make sure to share the video with your friends and let them know about the channel.